Hello, hello, Mordimer here, and today I would like to show you a very nice game played in Wegense in the year 2000, and it was Chorus Reserve Group, and we have Alexandra Kosteniuk, so everybody knows Alexandra, but at that time she was only 15 years old teenager, and her ranking already was 2409 points, and her opponent, Carol-Peter Gouw. 39 years old gentleman, and his ranking at that time 2172, but 10 years earlier he was already on 2315 ranking, so he was definitely very solid player. And I needed some better quality picture of Mr. Gouw. I couldn't find it in internet, so I contacted him and he answered and shared a much better quality picture, so we can enjoy that picture. Thank you, Mr. Gouw, for being the kind. I really appreciate that. And also, I make a short interview. I ask a couple of questions about this game, and he said that, of course, he know how strong Alexandra is at that time. He's 2400 plus player, and he said, okay, I didn't have a chance in any positional play that would take, you know, she would outplay me. So I decided to go all in and play sharp game, and then let's see what's gonna happen. And he also said, I found it an honor to play in the Chorus Reserve Master Group. And every game that time I was happy to play. So he really enjoyed. This was the strongest tournament he had the chance to play. So without further ado, let's jump into the game. Alexandra as white open with e4. We have e6, French defense. And now knight f3. So not the most popular d4, but knight f3. We have d5. And now knight c3 by Alexandra Kosteniuk. So a two knights variation. So for those who don't want to follow any orthodox lines of French defense, this is the way. Maybe, you know, you can try this. And here knight on f6 is the most popular. d4 it's also quite popular. D takes on e4 is playable. So black has a wide range of options. It's up what kind of position they want to reach. But here Mr. Gouw play bishop on b4, and here e5 by Kosteniuk. So pretty classical pawn in the French defense, now taking this f6 square, so black can't develop easily. Knight on e7, and now h4. Nowadays people say, okay, this is alpha zero move, and of course it's the year 2000, so Alexandra Kosteniuk couldn't play alpha zero moves, but this idea was brought to chess by Alexander Aliekhin. And he was the first who played h4, h5, h6 against the French defense. And, you know, this was 100 years ago. We have c5 played by Mr. Gouw. And now knight b5, because knight is not pinned, okay? This is the pawn still on d2, so there is no pin. This is why we have knight on b5. And now Mr. Gouw just castle, which is the best move in the position. However, he could also try something like c4, protecting this d6, controlling d6 square. But maybe it's not the best idea here. C3, bishop c5, and now d3. Queen b6, it looks quite dangerous, attacking f2, attacking the knight. But after knight b on d4, knight b on c6, putting more pressure to the center. D takes on c4, now exchanging the knights. C takes on d4. And now, for example, bishop b4, exchange all the pieces, and actually, queen d2, d takes on c4, bishop takes on c4, and white have one extra pawn, which black probably gonna take, because it's a quite weak pawn, and it will be difficult to push it and, you know, get some advantage. By Stockfish, the position is estimated as equal, but probably, you know, it's easier to play it as white. But here in this position, Mr. Gouw play castle. And it's always very double-edged decision to play this castle on the king sides or not in the French defense. Personally, I play French defense, but I really don't like to play the castle here. Black has to be very, very precise to get, you know, any chances, and little mistake can be decisive. We have c3 by Kosteniuk, kicking the bishop, bishop a5, and now d4. So pretty classical, a6, kicking the knight, but knight jumping to d6 now. And this knight gonna be very, very naughty. So for now, black don't have opportunity to take it out. And also keep in mind that this knight always watching an f7. So black have to be very careful. We have c takes on d4. So as I said, Mr. Gouw gonna play very sharp chess, and now this pawn is under attack and is also pinned. So white has to do something about that. Knight on d4 is actually really bad move. So knight on d4 and knight b on c6, knight c6, knight c6, and now this pawn is under attack. So white have to do something, queen h5 for example, defending, but it doesn't work because knight can take on e5 anyway. Queen e5, now bishop e7, and this knight gonna fall. So and a knight f7, trying to get some material before you know, capturing, but rook f7 and position of black is much better. Knight king is still in the center. Black has this semi-open file, and also the queen is under attack. So black has a quite nice advantage here. So of course not knight on d4, this is probably losing, but bishop on d3, this is very strong move. And here we have d takes on c3, but this is actually the last chance to play the defending move. So h6 was enough, h6 first, and then black can try to continue attack. And now this is very annoying pin, so white probably would play b4, and after bishop on c7, attacking the knight, winning the pawn. So that's probably the continuation. C takes on d4, knight b on c6, and the position is probably equal, and both sides can continue to play. Also, what was possible here is f5, because it cannot be taken en passant, because the knight is hanging. And then the same, for example, b4, knight on c8, and just c takes on d4, knight on c6, and also can play. So it's a matter of taste, but probably h6 was better than f5. But here we have d takes on c3, and now we have very serious threat, you know, taking on b2. What white can play? What would you play as white? This is quite important question. This is very critical moment of the game. So first I show you very sneaky idea for white, which actually doesn't work. So if b takes on c3, this is very natural to attack the king and the rook. And if bishop on d2, then bishop on a1 is losing. It's losing. And I will show you why, but not now, because I will show you the main line is a very, very similar one. But if black actually in this position are not greedy and takes on d2, then it's winning for black. Queen on d2, knight b on c6, and now look at this. Black have two extra pawns and the game is very, very comfortable. Also, queen is on d2, not on d1. And this is also very important. And you will understand why very soon. So b takes on c3 doesn't work. What if castle? Castle also is not the greatest idea. h6, as I said, this is very important move. Bishop c2 with the idea of, you know, setting some checkmate. And now knight on d7, queen d3, f5, and that's enough. E takes on f6, knight on f6, now defending h7, but also attacking the knight. Okay, so knight c8, rook on c8, and black stands better here and gonna have extra pawns and win the game. And there is no attack on the king side. King is totally safe and there is no this annoying pawn on e5, so everything is fine and black stands just much, much better. However, Alexandra Kosteniuk didn't play any of this move. So no castle, no b takes on c3. She also goes all in, but seems like she calculates better. So bishop takes on h7, check. And if the bishop is taken, actually knight g5 with the idea queen h5 and mating on h7. So king on g6, queen d3 with check, now f5 blocking, but then h5. So this h4 move was pretty important. Now h5 ideas here. And now king h6, and look at this. This is double attack on f7, so winning the queen is in the air. However, first white should play b takes on c3. Otherwise, this would be the idea with the check, promoting to the queen, and black have, you know, upper hand and can also be dangerous. So b takes on c3 first, and now what to play? Black doesn't have much possibilities because queen c7, then knight on e6 with the discovered check attacking the queen, so not possible. Queen on b6 and now knight on e6 anyway, king h7, knight f8 with check, king g8 and now h6. And now black doesn't have good moves. Even taking this knight is doesn't work because h takes on g7. Now checkmate is coming, so black doesn't have much choice. King on g7, but now queen on g3, knight g6, bishop h6, and also checkmate is coming. So look at this. Look at this. Everything is covered. So king even can't escape from here. King h7, now bishop f8 with check, king g8, now queen g6 with check, and now queen f7, that would be a checkmate. So taking bishop would be just deadly. This is why Mr. Gouw play king on h8. And here another very precise move by Alexandra Kosteniuk is almost everything is winning now, but the most precise move here is king on f1. And now there is no more threat here. There is no more threat. So we have c takes on b2, bishop takes on b2, and now this bishop can be also very, very deadly. The last chance to prolong the game for Mr. Gouw would be knight on g8, but it also doesn't help because bishop on c2 and we know already what's gonna happen here. For example, knight on d7, queen on d3, checkmate is coming, and now f5, e takes on f6, knight takes on f6, and now h5. So white even don't need to care about this knight. If knight is taken, then actually the end of the game would be very, very beautiful. h6, now rook on f7, defending. And now feel free to pause the video. I know this is the sideline, but this is very beautiful tactic. So find the checkmate in 3 moves while I enjoy my cup of tea. Okay, ready? So congratulations, and I think it's very, very beautiful sideline. Queen on h7 with check. This is just awesome. So knight on h7, this is the only move. And now h takes on g7 with check. So also the only move is rook takes on g7, and now rook h7 checkmate. This would be very, very beautiful checkmate because this rook is pinned. So if you found this, congratulations. You have very nice tactical skills, but Mr. Gouw didn't go for knight on g8. He preferred to play f6 and try to defend this way, but here Alexandra play another precise move, and this is the best move in the position, knight on g5. And now this bishop is deadly, so there is one idea of playing, you know, take this knight, and now this bishop is unuseful. The problem is queen can come on h8, so black cannot defend all the threats. Mr. Gouw play knight on g8, and then we have bishop takes on g8, king takes on g8, and now h takes on g8. So we have mating ideas here, and mate is coming, the knight controlling f7, very naughty knight. I told you this is very naughty knight. So here, rook f2, check. That is the last move of Mr. Gouw. And after king on f2, he resigned the game. I'm not sure why he played this move, maybe just for fun, but there is nothing he can do. Checkmate is coming on h8, checkmate is coming on f7. You cannot stop both, maybe by playing queen on d6, but it also doesn't work because queen h8 with check, king f7 and now g6. King can take it because a checkmate is coming to h5, so king e7, now queen g7. King e8, and now this is just a checkmate. So this is why in this position Carol-Peter Gouw resigned the game. So very beautiful attack by young Alexandra Kosteniuk, only 15 years old, but also remember, to create the masterpiece, to create a beautiful game like this one, beautiful miniature, you always need two players for that. So also, thank you Carol-Peter Gouw for going for this double edge variations. Everything could happen. And yeah, we have the very nice game masterpiece here. So more quality content is coming. If you don't want to miss any, press subscribe, smash the bell button. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.